you know, shocking that people think that that's okay to get out there and act like that. You know, just it's a reckless behavior with a firearm.
Jaw-dropping video into the Fox 10 newsroom showing what appears to be young men dancing with guns in their hands in a gas station parking lot in West Mobile.
And tonight, the sheriff is calling that behavior reckless and brazen. He says he's going to do something about it.
This is the Stimpson Administration and the Mobile Chief of Police deal with what they have called a power struggle between the two. It's video you'll only see on Fox 10 News.
The video is pretty jarring to see.
That's a 100-round drum that was on the one you just saw. And it's a AR platform pistol. The one you just saw with the wooden stock is an SKS or AK-47 type pistol, that one right there. And then the one flashing the laser with the cup in his hand is a pistol with a laser on it.
It appears to show young men, all armed, dancing in a gas station parking lot, smiles on their faces. The time on the video says it's just after 1 a.m. Mobile County Sheriff Paul Burch showing me this video, and he says it's not even in an area with a high crime rate.
There are a lot of people who take wild guesses where this happened, but it's actually in West Mobile at Greenlot and Oakwood.
The sheriff says the activity on its own isn't technically illegal due to the open carry law passed 2 years ago in Alabama. But he says it's about the people in the video.
We received the video a few weeks ago. You've got these guys riding around and conducting themselves like this with firearms.
Mobile Police Chief Paul Prine, who is on administrative leave and tells us he's retiring, says he showed the video on March 2nd to Mobile Mayor Sandy Stimpson, stressing the need for better access to the Gulf Coast Technology Lab to identify the people in the video.
Do you know that my criminal investigators have to go to the sheriff and his people that run his intelligence unit to do the same thing that my people are required to do?
We're told the Gulf Coast Technology Lab is used by 43 different law enforcement agencies to help them identify suspects and fight crime more efficiently. In my sit-down interview with the mayor on Friday, to some extent, he agreed with the chief of police.
The point that Chief Prine was making and showing that video to me and to others is that, you know, this is what we're dealing with, and we need the Gulf Coast Technology Center to be able to identify these individuals and give us information on a timely basis. I do not disagree with that, okay?
The sheriff says he's still studying the video and feels action should be taken.